sure you guys check out our channel partner, GamerSups. Go to gamersups.gg and use code Zach for 10% off.
Cucumber.
Keto friendly, zero cal, zero sugar. It's all sorts of good stuff in there for you. Use code Zach. Help out your boy. If you also want caffeine free, you can also check that out as well. May I recommend anything blue or dragon fruit? That's their top flavors. So check them out. Gamersubs.gg, code Zach. We're going to start right after this. Baby, give me a second. Something happened with my camera earlier, and this overhead shot, and I just want to make sure we get it right. All right, 6 a.m. standby, 7 a.m. in the house. Let's make sure things are working here.
Hello there.
You guys digging it? I don't normally play this track, but I'm digging it this afternoon. Let me tell you, I don't have the right screens. I thought I was, anytime you think you're ready and you're never ready. Anyway, people, it's finally here, a little bit later than what everybody else got it, but that's okay. It's my content, and it's gonna be awesome. The Pixel 7a is here, it's in the house. A big thank you to Google Canada and Made by Google for sending this out for review, for content making purposes, etc., etc. Thanks again. Couldn't do this kind of stuff without great partners like them. Thank you, Google. Appreciate it. All right. Now that we're out of the way there, all your disclosures and whatnot are down in the description. We're going to get that going here again. I just like the look of it on camera. And we're going to dive into this. We're going to do an unboxing. We're going to set it up. We are going to go through the menus and all that kind of good stuff. Our unboxing, comparison, setup. My wife has her Pixel 7 in the other room. I'm going to text her when I want her to bring the 7 in here so we can do a quick comparison. But they're very, very close in terms of what they look like and sizing and whatnot. I do have right here Pixel 7 Pro. Okay, she's over here. She's charging right now. Pixel 6a, which this is, you know, the 7a is a direct upgrade of this one right here. These two phones are supposed to be the exact same size, exact same dimensions. Just some differences there with it comes to when it comes to things like pixels per inch and things like that. Little minor things. Obviously, you have we're going from 60 hertz to 90 hertz over here. Big camera upgrade. A little bit, the battery's been shaved off a little bit. But we'll go through that stuff. We've been going through that for the last few weeks. I think most people know what those differences are and whatnot. Google sent me here. You guys can see this. This is the C Blue. They just call it C. Let me just see. If you guys can see that. All right. If you guys can see that. Let's see if that focuses in there. Yeah, the Pixel 7a 5G sub 6, 6.1 inches, 128 gigabytes, sea ocean. Okay. Pretty awesome box. Despite what some people say, Flossy. I love Flossy. Don't worry about him. I like the box. I like the simplicity. But before we dive into things, people, I got to let you guys know that the stream is being powered by StreamYard. Check them out, StreamYard.com. The link is down below. Very simple to use. You grab a mic, you grab a camera, away you go. There's nothing to install, nothing to download. Very simple to use. We've got music overlays. We got different cameras. We got different sounds, you know.
Cucumber.
Things like that. You can do whatever you need. You can bring up to 10 people. It all gets recorded on StreamYard's end. You can download the streams after and edit them and re-upload them. You have an awesome repurposing tool. So you can take out clips, push them directly to Reels, to TikTok, to YouTube Shorts. Awesome. So we appreciate the sponsorship. We appreciate the help around here, StreamYard. Love you. Love you lots. All right. People. Super chats, buy me a coffee, all that kind of good stuff is all open. Appreciate you guys being here. If you're new to the live streams, we dive into the live chat. We see who's here, and then we will get straight to this. I definitely want to make this not as quick, but I don't want to be dragging this out, you know, as much as we have to here. So as a matter of respect and whatnot, because you're taking your afternoon or evening, depending on where you are, to hang out with us here, I want to acknowledge the people that are here for the live stream. We appreciate you. And of course, if you're watching the replay, use the chapters I'll be putting in down below, and I'll probably be shaving off this intro part and everything for the replay. I haven't decided how I'm going to approach this. We tried a little experiment yesterday over on another website, tried uploading it here. It bombed. So we're back to doing the streams over here, I think. I think we'll probably keep the streams here for the most part. All right, going to the live chat. And we still have the forest fire smoke going on here, and it's tickling my throat all day. Jonathan Rash, how you doing, sir? Clint Neely. Clint is one of our channel members. You can also become a channel member by clicking the join button. There's also a link pinned at the top of the live chat there. Channel members get priority chat. They get emojis to use and things like that. And we're also going to be doing some private live streams here pretty quick as well. All sorts of access. Follow you on socials. It's a way to support the channel. It's a way to be highlighted. And it's a way to show your love. So think about becoming a channel member. Clint, this one's for you.
All right.
Love you and your daughter, Savannah, I think she is. I think is her name. So hello to you both. Appreciate you guys being here. Genos is in the house. Regular member and always and everybody's live streams here on the tech community and whatnot. Trey Foster, how you doing? Glad you're here. Also here, Track is Fire. Dennison Carlson coming in from Sweden. This guy's always in my Discord. He's always like, hey guys, what's up? I'm playing WoW. And that's and then he kind of like just dips out. I love him for that. And also, again, yeah, Forest Fire Smoke is nuts over here too. You guys got it over there too, hey? Ooh, I'm heading out to Banff this weekend. And I'm hoping that the Forest Fire Smoke is not that bad. Now, speaking of the Discord, I should have had this ready to go. I'm going to put a 24-hour link. This link will be used, available for the next 24 hours. I'm going to generate a new link here, one-day link. And so if you want to come join us on the Discord and have some fun and silliness and, you know, see the behind-the-scenes stuff right there in the live chat, join. If you're using a different name that's over here, please let us know. Just ping me at Zach. Hey, Zach, this is so-and-so. We'll do a quick verification because we don't have all the bots and everything like that set up yet. And away we go. We got Mech1164. How you doing? He's also in the Discord. There you guys go. All right. Pixel 7a. I'm really excited about this. Ever since the rumors and whatnot about the upgrades, the value of this thing at 500 US, it's 600 Canadian, I believe. Absolutely awesome. They upgraded the camera, the refresh rate, all sorts of great stuff. It's going to be great. They added some focus features. I can't wait to get into this. All right, Pixel 7a, let's get into this. Hopefully this is zoomed in enough for you guys so you guys can see it and whatnot. All right, so we don't need our knife, which is a shame. We're gonna put the Millennium Falcon over there and this right here, just kind of out of the way. 6A can go over here. All right. You guys saw the backs and everything like that. All there is just some information on the bottom here. Nothing you need to really see. Serial numbers and whatnot. And I'm going to be making this my full-time device. I'll be putting my SIM card in here and everything. So, and I'm really glad they sent me this blue color. So anyway, enough, right? Enough. Get into it. So pull tab number one. Pulling tab number two. I don't know if they're numbered, but... All right, and boom. Ooh. Look at that. Look at that. Let's just put that aside for a quick sec. Ooh. Ooh, it's flat. It's flat. I love it. Inside here, you're also going to get USB-C to USB-C cable, OTG cable here for transferring data, and then some books and whatnot, and SIM ejection tool right there. Okay? That's it. No charger. No charger. All right, there she is. People, Google Pixel 7a. I really dig the visor, this kind of brushed thing on here. Look at this visor. Look at this camera. This thing means business. Peel it with respect. I did peel it with respect. Look at this visor. There's a little, what's on the top here? Oh, a little dust or whatever. I'm not sure if it's from inside the box. Yeah, look at this. Look at this thing. This thing is a beauty. Look at this. All right. So on the left side here, we've got some antenna bands. Nothing at all. There is a SIM tray here in Canada. I'm not sure if the U.S. versions get this or not, but we have a SIM tray here for Canada. On the bottom, let's just take a quick tour. Speaker grill, USB type. Oops, there we go. On the bottom here, speaker grill, USB type C. And on the right side, volume rocker. I'm not sure if that's going to focus. Volume rocker. Oh, there we go. Volume rocker and the power button. And on the top, looks like we got another mic, some antenna bands, and looks pretty uniform. I mean, we have two bands at the top here and on the opposite side as well, and then towards the bottom on both sides, and then the bottom. On the bottom, there's this one one band all by itself. And on the top, you got two. All right. Now, as for finish, yes, it's a glossy finish, and I can already see my fingerprints on it. Oh, I couldn't tell from other people's videos if this was a frosted finish or whatnot. But you know what? We're going to roll with it because Later Case sent me out some cases. We're going to put a couple of those on here, and we'll see which one looks the nicest. I have my eyes on the Willy Blue, but this is cool. All right, so shall we do the honors of peeling off? All right, let's just put this here. All right, quick question here from Sephium. I'm interested to know if cellular connectivity is better than the 7 Pro. Excuse me. You know what's funny about that is I actually personally have not had any issues, and I'm wondering if it's a carrier thing, because I haven't heard about it with all carriers. I haven't had any issues with my carrier here. I get 5G in my basement. So I'm not sure how I would test that, otherwise, you know, getting devices for all the other carriers and traveling around and whatnot. But anyway, let's dive in here. Okay, people, where's our camera? Let's take off this... the screen protector, if you will, the cover. I don't use screen protectors. I'm sorry, people. I live dangerously. I'm not a fan of screen protectors. If you're a screen protector company, I'm sure you do great things, but I don't put screen protectors on. My wife, on the other hand, with her Pixel 7, has got a big slab of glass on there. So, we're going to peel this off. All right, here we go. And that's the cleanest it will ever be. Look at this. Look at this flat screen. I like it. Look at this flat screen. Look at this flat screen. Now, before we do anything else, look at this flat screen. Before we do anything else, I'm going to send a quick text message to my wife. She's in the next room. I'm going to have her bring her Pixel 7 into this room. We'll pop it out of her case so we can do a quick look at it. So I'm going to let you guys look at that there. I'm going to grab my Pixel 7 Pro. And we'll get the 7 in here just so we can do a quick comparison. Okay. Hopefully she's not on the phone or something like that. I can show you guys real quick comparison here with the 7 Pro. So let's take a quick look here. So size difference. Let's get this box out of the way. 7 Pro right here. And then here's the 6A. So I think we're all lined up here. Oh, and the 7 is here. So you guys go ahead and just take a quick look at that. We got 7 Pro, 7A, 6A, and then I've got the 7 right here. There's your case, my darling. All right, here is the 7. Here is the 7, all right? So let's move this. Look at this glamour shot. That's actually your complete lineup right now if you look at the Google website. All right, so let's line that up. I know like my OCD is going off here because it's not all even. I'm doing my best here, people. So there you go. You can see that the 7A is a little bit shorter than the 7. It's the same. These two phones, the 7A and the 6A, are the exact same in terms of dimensions. The weight is a little bit heavier on the 7A, I believe. But we'll take a look at that. But there's the lemon right there. This is the 7 Pro. Yeah, right there. So you guys have a really good idea. And it's the same sort of glossy finish that you have on the 7 there. But there's your complete lineup right now with Google devices. That's a really nice shot right there. That looks good. All right, I have to give this back to my wife now. She really loves this. All right. She's grinning. She saw the blue phone. She saw this right here. She saw this and she's like, "Oh, that looks nice." No, no. Listen, wife. Shout out to Caseology. This is a cool case. That's my phone. Can you close the door? Thank you. Love you. All right, cool. All right, people. It's a wholesome show. All right. Cool. All right. I told her earlier, I said, "Hey, I would need to do a comparison." She's like, "But it's my phone. Like, I'm on it all day." All right. So, in the meantime, since we're kind of done looking at the comparison and we want to do a setup on the 7A, what we'll do is we'll put the Pixel 7 Pro back on the charger there. We're just topping up right now. I'm going to take the 6A. I don't believe. Let me just clear out the notifications on here. Yeah, we'll keep this one off to the side. Over there. All right. And we got these little doodads here. Put those in here. All right. Guess we'll keep the box. I don't know. I guess right there? I don't know. There we go. All right, people. Let's get into the setup and whatnot. I do want to give you guys a really good idea of what this color is like. So I'm going to turn on my regular lighting in here. And so you guys have a really good idea. So I have the stage lighting is off now, but so you have a really good idea. It's definitely like a baby blue, if you wanted to give it that. They call it C, but it's definitely like a baby blue. Here's another look right here. And another look over here. Oop. Okay. So it's not, I've seen some videos and some pictures that show up being really dark. It's not, it's very light colored. Okay, so you guys have an idea. I'm wearing a white hoodie, you can tell. Someone do me a favor. Do me a favor. And here, let's do this. Because I know you guys love doing this. Let's bring that down. And someone do me a favor and just get a screenshot of this. And tag me on the Twitters or something like that, okay? All right, cool. So yeah, there you guys go. There's a better look at the color and whatnot. Let's go back to the regular lighting. So you have an idea. All right. So we'll put this back down here. We'll turn our regular stage lighting back on. All right. And we're going to dive into the live chat here, see who's here and talk to the people and whatnot. So let's go through here. Oh, my headphone wire is not cooperating. There we go. All right, cool. Gino says I've had no connectivity issues either. Let's go ahead and skip that. Oh, wait a minute. No, actually, that's a killer song. There we go. We'll leave it right there. We got Connor. He's another channel member. Connor.
All right.
That one's for you, buddy. Appreciate you showing up here. We're going to turn down this music just a little bit because it's a little intense. Let's take a look here. Trey Foster. Screen protectors are the worst. Well, some people need them. I'm lucky enough to work from home, and I'm super careful with all my electronic devices. I can count on one hand how many times in my lifetime I've dropped a device. Knock on wood. Okay. Hopefully that doesn't happen with this. Deception says, more specifically, is the 5G UC better than the 607 Pro? I don't know, and I don't know how we're going to measure that. You know who's going to be really good at measuring that? Ben at Lover of Tech. Seriously, he's got some of the best Pixel coverage out there. Pixel 7a, Google Pixel 7a will be the phone of the year. I think it will be. I think in terms of this price point at 500 US, at 600 Canadian, whatever that is in euros and whatever that may be in euros or in pounds, whatnot, this packs a lot and is really, really good. We talked about the 6A earlier this week. I think the 6A still has a lot to offer, especially in its price point for 350 US. But yeah, Google's definitely making it competitive out there. Google, curved screens are dumb. I don't know if they're dumb, but I'm not the biggest fan. I mean, let's take a quick look. Let me just bring the 7 Pro over here. So many pixels. Okay, here is the 7 Pro, and I don't mind the curvature on this. I'm on record, and I'll say it again, I really thought the Galaxy S23 Ultra did a good job of the curvatures on theirs, because it was just a little bit of curve, enough to give that curve feel and look, but it wasn't as intense as this. So if the rumors are true, we've seen some CADs and possibly leaks out there of the Pixel 8 and 8 Pro. Apparently, it's supposed to be flat, and that would be really, really cool. That would be really, really cool. Anyway, Connor prefers the flat over the curved. You can't tell the difference between Pixel 7 and Pixel 7A. You can. The 7A, the 7 was a little bit taller. I think it's the same width. You'd have to check. They're so close in terms of specs and size and whatnot, but the 7A is definitely a little bit smaller. It's got this great handling and whatnot. So we're going to turn that on. We're going to boot that up here in just a second. Let's take a look here. The wife wants, the wife gets. Absolutely. Caseology for the win. Absolutely. They're actually sending me out some cases as well. So looking forward to covering their stuff. And just so you guys all know, my extended Google Pixel A coverage will be on Zach Talks Pixel. So if you're not subscribed over there, head on over. I haven't done a lot over there for a while, but I've issued myself a challenge for the next quarter and for the rest of this quarter and next quarter to make 24 videos. I've got some ideas thanks to Roberto Blake. So we'll be going in on that. Hopefully I can get the first video up tomorrow, which will be a lot of talking head and showing the B-roll from this live stream. Okay. That'll be fun. I love how significant other of every tech creator always has a baller smartphone. Well, you know what? That's thanks to Google Canada and made by Google for sending that out. Because they did send out, this, the 6A, the 7. The 7 Pro is from my carrier. Yeah. I like the limited blue on the Pixel 4A. Yes, it was. I remember that orange. And, of course, we got the coral now on the 7A, which is really nice. Going through here. Gino says, I work construction and don't use a screen protector or case. I do like to live dangerously. I can't do a British accent, but that's the total Austin Powers line. Mech says, Zach, see if the 7A you received has wave. The 4901 is just sub 6. It's 50 or more USD for wave here. I will check, but I'm betting it doesn't. Hey, technically T in the house. We're going to give you one of these.
Hello there.
Just create and don't think about all the other logistics. I'm not sure what he's referring to. But yeah, there we go. Appreciate you, T, coming through. Thanks for being here this afternoon. Appreciate it. T's always been a good inspiration, and he's the case guy. Let's just say it. He does great case reviews and content and whatnot. His content overall is just really, 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 really good. All right, people, let's get this thing on. Let's boot her up. I've got my Titan key on standby. We're going to go ahead and power this up. Oh, wouldn't that be funny if there was no power? Okay. I hope there's something in here. Oh my gosh, is it completely dead? Okay. Whew, that took a while. All right, here we go. Look at that flat screen. Look at that. That's nice. Wow, there we go. Now, because there's personal information going into the phone and whatnot, there'll be several times where I'm going to have the camera not, you know, showing the screen and whatnot. So I hope you guys understand. I'm pretty sure you do understand. So keep that in mind. Welcome to your Pixel English US. Okay, does it allow English Canada? Because we do spell some things a little bit different here. There is a straight English, and I'm wondering if that... Oh, look, it does say Canada. English Canada, because we spell like neighbor, color different here, and stuff like that. Get started. Connect to your mobile network. All right, people. I'm going to connect. Oh, you know what? That requires a SIM card. So let me grab my SIM card here out of my Pixel 6 Pro. Sorry, excuse me, Pixel 7 Pro. Yeah. I don't know if this is eSIM enabled or not, but hey, it's asking for a card, so let's give it what it wants. And I'll be doing a fresh install as well. I'm not gonna be copying over apps or anything. I'll be doing a fresh install. All right, give me a second here. So, SIM, I think we all have SIM ejection tools kicking around everywhere. Go ahead and pop that. Like the brushed rails too. Nice touch. Okay. And we'll pop that SIM card in. Because what that does is it registers it to my account with my carrier. Okay, SIM card is in there. I can't remember if it... Okay, so there we go. Now we want to connect to the Wi-Fi. All right, so searching for network. And we're going to go ahead and log into that. And I can't remember the screens here, otherwise I would show you guys what's going on here. Interesting. Oh, you know what it is? I think I have to add the permission through my Wi-Fi here at the house. So... All right, cool. I had to add the permission there with my Wi-Fi here. All right, so we'll just put that there. And... All right, so getting your phone ready. This may take a few minutes. All right, so we'll just leave that right there. I'm gonna pop my SIM, my thing back into my 7 Pro, put that back on the charger. Of course, this thing also has wireless charging. I'll give you guys a demo there. So copy apps and data. This is where you would go through the steps of copying over apps and data. Myself personally, I like to do a fresh install, like freshly install the apps I use and whatnot. And I know that takes time and whatnot and can be annoying, but that's just the thing. I think a lot of you guys are also the same way. So I'm actually going to skip this part here and don't copy. Okay, so checking info. Again, we'll just put that down here. All right, so this is the part where I have to log in with my my Google, my main Google, my personal Google and whatnot. So, leave that here and enjoy the views. Give me a second here. Maybe I can, let's see here. So let's create a banner. All right, There we go. So if anybody tunes in, they know what's going on here. So enjoy the tunes, people, while I do this over here. I think I'll be able to actually authorize this via my Pixel 7 Pro rather than using my Titan key because it's a trusted device, but don't quote me on that. I'll let you guys know what happens here. Give me a quick second. All right. Here we go. So it's asking me for two-step verification, just as like I thought it would. I can use a secured key with Bluetooth, use secured key with NFC, or use secured key with USB. So you guys know we've done this before. Let me just pull it out here. Titan key. Get yourself one of these, okay? So we're gonna plug that into the bottom. And away we go. So you just got to go through the steps here. And just plug the key in. I've plugged the key in. It blinks. Allow access. You say yes. And you touch the gold pins on it. And it unlocks. Now this is cool. This is new. We saw this last time when we did the 7 Pro. It is asking me who will be using the device. I'll be using it or my child, which is really cool. I'll definitely be setting up a device in the future here for my kids and using this feature here. This is really, really neat. All right, so I'm gonna hit next. I'll be using it. And then it's going through the regular terms of service and whatnot. I agree to everything. And all right, now it's getting the account information. Again, there's personal information on here, so I can't really show you guys much. I just say yes to everything, to all the terms of service, because it's cool. Limited warranty. So there's a limited warranty information screen that comes up, and you can click on whatever your preference is there, English, Canada, French, US, English, US, Spanish, and you can read through the warranty. That's kind of a new screen right there. And then we're gonna set up a PIN. And once we get to the fingerprint unlock, here we go, here we go. Let's do this right now. All right, people, we're gonna do the fingerprint unlock. We're gonna set this up right now. I don't know if I can take my Titan key out. Sometimes I may have missed the screen where it says you can take it out, but we're gonna set up the fingerprint unlock. Now, my understanding of this fingerprint unlock is should be the same as the 7 Pro. I don't know if they've done any sort of improvement or whatnot. I haven't seen any documentation or whatnot, but we're gonna set this up. So it gives you all the jibber jabber there as usual. And how to set up. So we'll start. And here we go. Here, I'm gonna move my mic down here so you guys can hear me. And I think you need to move your finger around a little bit. I usually do my left. Sorry, I do my right hand because I'm right-handed. And then I'll do my left. So I have it in there. Sometimes people will do both hands twice. Okay, so just the tip right now. So we're doing just the tip. And I'll move my phone around there just a little bit. There we go. First fingerprint is done. We're going to add another. We're going to add the left hand now, because sometimes I unlock with the left hand. And pretty straightforward. You wait for it. You just touch, and then you wait for kind of a haptic feedback. Hopefully you guys aren't getting too much reflection there. Okay, Okay, now we're doing just a tip.
Just a tip.
Okay. And have I said out how much I love the haptics on the Google Pixel? There, done. Okay, I'm gonna hit next here, and I'm gonna just move off screen here because I'm not sure if there'll be anything. Okay, here we go, check this out. Set up face unlock, face unlock. So I think what we're gonna do here is I'm gonna move you guys here, and I'm gonna put my regular lighting on, and I'm going to take off my headphones, and we're going to set up the face unlock. So hopefully you guys can see that okay. Okay, so face unlock. Can I do it from here with you guys? Let's see. Okay, so keep in mind if you normally wear eyeglasses. I'll show you guys this here. Keep in mind if you normally wear eyeglasses, you can wear them during setup. Looking at the phone can unlock it even when you don't intend to. Your phone can also be unlocked by someone who looks a lot like you, so they're just, you know, pretty standard stuff, right? So, agree. So, on the next screen, hold your phone at eye level. And away we go. So, let me just put you guys over here. So, I'm just going to move this out of the way. So, eye level and start. I want to show you guys this. So, it has this thing where you put your head in. This is what it looks like. It's red right now because it's not detecting a face. Okay, so that's what's happening right now, but that's what you get. Okay, so let's, all right, so I have to try again. All right, here we go. So try again. Okay, so you want to move your head around, look more directly, tilt your head up, it's telling me, tilt your head down. Looks good, it says. Cool, hit done. And now we're on to the next screen here. Continue setup. So we'll just bring it over here. And let me get my headphones back on. All right. Let's continue the setup here. So we just did the face unlock there. Continue setup. So we'll continue. And again, I'm moving the phone out because I don't know what personal information. Sometimes it just surprises you with, here's your email address and all your information. All right, so it's asking me about using the Hey Noodle, voice match and whatnot. And I'm just saying yes, because it already has my voice match. And the assistant. And it's loading up here again. Just a standard load screen, kind of loading up. Okay. All right, anything else? So through here, you guys can see here, we can set up, get instant translations, identify music around you, set up always on display, whatnot. So a lot of these features I love using. Identify music around you. I like that feature. And always on display. Let's take a look here. We're gonna turn that on. We love always on display. Let's take a look here. Change how text is displayed. So, again, you can adjust the size of the font, the size of whatnot. I usually do a little bit bigger font. And as for the display, I'm usually good there. I just like the font a little bit bigger. And I think we will also bold that font because it just makes it easier. High contrast text. Changes text colors to black or white to minimize contrast with the background. So if I go like this, okay, we'll do that. We'll leave that high contrast text on. Actually, no, maybe not. We'll just make it a little bit bigger, okay? There we go. I'm surprised it hasn't actually asked me about navigation yet. Then as emergency, set up another email account. We're not gonna do that. I review additional apps. Give me a second here, because sometimes the review. Okay, so in here, these are the additional apps that will be downloaded and put on here. I use all these things, podcasts, translate, everything. So I'm just gonna hit okay to all of them. And we're not gonna add another email address. We're not gonna worry about prepare for an emergency because it should pull that from my account that it is. Control info that's on the lock screen. Okay, so control info that's on the lock screen. Show all notifications, show sentiment content only when unlocked. Show notifications. Don't show notifications at all. So I usually leave it on all and get instant translations. So again, this is the instant translation stuff. We'll hit okay. And I think yeah, I think we're good to go here. So I'm just going to hit the next button here. All right. So get tips and tricks in your inbox. Anybody that's ever set up a Pixel, you know that right away you get an email, a welcome email and whatnot. I usually just say yes because it's cool to kind of get those emails and whatnot. I don't mind. They don't send a lot. They don't send a lot at all. And okay, here we go. Swipe to navigate. I love Pixel navigation. I really, really do. Learn gestures to go home, go back, switch apps, da 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 da. So try it. Of course, I want to try it. Swipe up. So nice. Okay, sorry about the reflection there, people. Swipe to go back. So there we go. Nice. Swipe to switch apps. So up. Nice. Done. And says all set. You're all set to use your device. So swipe up to go home. And boom. We are all set, people. We're set. We are in there. Yes. All right, people. I'm guessing I could take out my Titan key now. It never said not to. So we'll take that out. Flip this baby over for a second. Ew, there's a little hair there. What is that? All right. And let's dive into the live chat. I know you guys have been talking amongst yourselves and whatnot. Hopefully someone's finding some value out of the setup here and whatnot. This is the one song I hate. All right, there we go. Let's go through the live chat because I see some new people here. So Mech says, if I didn't already have the 7, I'd be all over this. Yeah, I don't. Honestly, when you put them side by side, I don't see why we go from 7 to 7A. It really doesn't make much sense or anything. I want to be as excited as Zach when I get the Pixel 7. You should be, man. I love getting new pixels and everything like that. Like, I already know what to expect and everything, and they just make the whole setup process so easy and everything like that. I'm just going through here. Ross Nim, how you doing? Glad you're at the stream. Glad you're here. Tech for your needs. Glad you're here. Thanks for coming through. BG Tech Life, thanks for coming through. Josh Tech Gamer, how you doing, buddy? Guys, if you guys like desk setups and like mice and you know, cool desk pads like this and stuff like that, check out Josh. He's a good friend. He puts out good content. Josh is a good guy. Josh, I'm going to give you one of these because, you know.
All right, all right, all right.
You're a good guy. AR1980, how you doing? Glad you're here. Nice looking device. What are the haptics like on the phone so far? It feels the same. It feels very, very familiar. It feels like a Pixel. It's hard to explain, but Pixel haptics have their own feel. But it feels the same as my 6 Pro. Or sorry, my 7 Pro. It feels the same as the 6A. Yeah. We're going to be going through the later cases here in just a little bit. Shelly saves the day. Shelly, this one's for you.
Oh, yeah.
With respect, of course. Glad you're here, Shelly. Thanks for coming through. All right, going through here. Yeah, plus one to Pixel haptics. Mason, I want a Titan key now. Yeah, you. If you want to lock down your Google account, you need one. It's not going to save you from Man in the Middle or from getting like we've seen some YouTubers and whatnot. But nothing can be done unless you've got that key. I'm actually surprised that my Pixel 7 Pro didn't go off. My Pixel 7 Pro saying, hey, someone's trying to get into your account. Probably because I have the Titan key. Oh, you know what? Here we go. I can't show you guys because it shows the email. New sign in on Google Pixel 7a. Your account was signed in, not used secure account. So I can click on check activity and it's going to say, you know, was this you? Yes, it was me. Done. But it wasn't there to unlock it. Okay. And I've also got a security alert on my other emails and whatnot. So they did go through. They did go through. But it wasn't required to use the phone to unlock it. So to set it up, I had to use the Titan key just the way it should be. Yeah, the later cases do look nice. We're going to be going through them. They're over here. We're going to be popping a couple on there. If iPhones had swipe right, side to go back. I use both sides, man. I just know that if I swipe, it's going to go back and everything. I really like it. It throws me off sometimes when I use my iPhone. I love the desk pads there. Yeah, this desk pad right here is, I can't remember who did this one, but I just love the look of this and everything. I like how loud it is, and it digs all. It's with my colors and things like that. So I could get Linus. Yeah, do you guys remember that? Yeah, that was despite having a key on there. That was someone clicked on something and malware was downloaded. And where we go, and IR also says he has a Titan key. All right, cool. So let's do face unlock. Is it gonna work with my headphones on? Oh, it may not work under this lighting with the headphones on. Nope. Okay, that's okay. All right, so this is the first time unlocking, so you do need to put the pin in. Okay, let's lock it again. Actually, we don't need to lock it. Okay. So, of course, you're going to get this message here saying, finish setting up your Pixel. We'll do that later. Now, okay, now it is unlocked because I think it detected my face. So let me just hold it here. Nope. Again, it might be dark in here. Oh, look at that. It did unlock. Boom. I just had to get a little bit closer. It did unlock. There we go. Fingerprint is decent. Fingerprint is decent, people. Oh my goodness. Oh my goodness. All right, let's go into YouTube here. Let me set up YouTube for the first time. And we'll take a look at some video here and whatnot. Let's take a look. All right, we're on YouTube. Okay, we're on YouTube. And I gotta turn off that autoplay thing. Not a fan of that. Let's take a look here. Going through, let's see. You guys are like, what is he subscribed to? What's going on here? Let's go. Yes, okay. Ooh, that looks good. Looks really good. Oh, hello. Let's skip that. Oops. I don't know. You never know what's going to show up on the shorts there. Thank goodness. Yeah, anyway. Maybe that wasn't such a good idea. But, yeah, who is that? I don't know what that is. Anyway, oops, it's a live show, people. But anyway, yeah, there's my most latest short. Yeah, using Opus there, as you guys know. Sure, Zach. Busted, right? Yeah, anyway, all set up. Looking good. I'll definitely be using the blur feature in the YouTube editor and taking that out. Oh, man. But yeah, there we go. Nice, beautiful, flat display. Now, let me go into settings here. And about phone. No, not about phone. Where do we want to go? System update. Okay, so there is a security update to be pushed through. This is obviously to get things updated, so we'll be installing that. Where's the oh yeah effect? Oh, okay, hold on.
Oh yeah.
Mason is asking, is this a hashtag gift from Google? No, this is from Google Canada. The hashtag gift from Google and Team Pixel thing is primarily a US and UK thing. Okay, so this is from Google Canada and made by Google. They consider me media. That's how it differentiates up here. But yes, Google did send it out. Okay, so anyway, that face unlock is pretty decent there. It looks like you have to be out under the proper lighting. But it looks like there's an update there, and away we go. I'm not going to go into my pictures or anything like that or anything because I still need to set things up there. I need to switch over my text messages from my other device. Let's take a selfie. Let me just make sure that this camera is set up. So there we go. Okay, so save location. Top shot. Okay, we'll leave all that on. There's an update for the camera, it says. So maybe we can update that first. Okay, we're going to update the camera first. It's just doing the update. Okay, you guys can see here, it's just doing a camera update right now. Okay. And look at that. You can actually see my office speaker. That's my wife's office there. She's playing music. I like to mess with her sometimes and just press pause and put on weird music because that's what I do. So we're gonna wait for that camera to update. Then we'll reload the camera. We'll take a selfie here together and then I'll bring it up on the Google Photos. All right, so let's get the chat here. I'm gonna pop you guys out here. I'm gonna use the pop out effect here, and so pop out chat. Get you guys on the screen here. All right, people. So we're gonna do a selfie here. And okay, so let's see. So we got the chat over there. I'm right here. And let's go ahead and use the 0.7 wide. And let's see if I can get you guys in here. Let me just turn this. All right, here we go. Everybody say hi. Hi. Let's do another one. All right, there we go. First couple selfies. You guys weren't waving. Come on, work with me here. All right, let's go into our Google Photos here. And we'll bring up that photo so you guys can see it. Hopefully that has been pushed. Hopefully that's been pushed to Google Photos. Let me just double check that. Oh, you know what? I haven't run the Google Photos app yet. So we need to turn that on. And we'll turn on backup. And I always do original quality because I pay for storage. And you do get 15 gigabytes for free. There's also a storage saver, as you guys know. Let me just show you the guys the screen here. So when you're first booting up your Google Photos, I think you guys are all pretty familiar with this. And I always turn off the mobile part there because that can destroy your data pretty quick. So original quality, confirm, and allow Google to send notifications. And then there's a bunch of stuff. So I'm not sure how quickly that's going to push to Google Photos because it doesn't have to load everything. But maybe what we'll do in the meantime is we will dive into the later cases. So let me just put this back here. In the meantime, we'll dive into the later cases. And yeah, again, thanks for coming through, everybody. I appreciate you guys being here this afternoon. We're coming up on 1 hour. I did want to keep this stream, you know, under 90 minutes. So let's grab those later cases. There's a 6A. Now, we went through these a little bit yesterday. There's also my latest video, but later case was cool enough to send me out Crimson, Willy Blue, and their gray black color. Okay, so we're gonna go into this. And I was really intrigued about using the blue. So let's get in here. All right. The white looks sharp. This is blue, man. Like a pepper. This is the blue. Yeah, this is the blue. I don't know if you can see it a little bit better on that, because I'm wearing a white hoodie. Unless you're talking about my hoodie. I don't think you're talking about my hoodie. Anyway, here is the Willy Blue later case. We're going to pop that on there. Love the packaging from later case. All right, so very simple. Just pop her in. We'll go top first, snap, and it just snaps in. There we go. You still have access to your buttons on the side here. Okay, full coverage with the camera. It's open on the top, it's open on the bottom, it's closed off on the side. That is the later case. Now it is raised ever so slightly. It is raised ever so slightly in the corners. So when you put the phone on a flat surface, it is raised up. And that's some nice, yeah, you get some additional grip there. It's not bulky. I like that. That looks good. Let's throw on the crimson as well. You can still see the colors of your device and everything like that. So let me throw on the crimson. And super easy to take off. Just kind of peel away on the corners there. Phone pops out. Okay. Put that aside. We'll grab this crimson. I'll show you guys the gray block here real quick. This is their classic. This is the gray black. And then they also have a completely black color as well. Okay. So we'll pop that there. Here's the crimson. This one's a statement as well. Let me know in the chat which color you guys like. Do you like Willy Blue or Crimson? Willy Blue or Crimson? Which one would you use? Okay. So we'll pop that in there. There we go. Mason Head says crimson. Ross says the blue. Yeah, I wouldn't call it Slam Boy certified, dude. It's definitely surface protection. Definitely surface protection. Jonathan likes the crimson. It looks good, man. It looks really good. That's a statement right there. Let me show you guys up here. Right? You can still see a bit of the camera visor around the edges there. So you still can still see some of the color there. We're going to pop that blue back on, though. Let's pop that blue back on. Got a little something on here. I'm not sure what's going on here. There we go. All right. All right. There's the blue there again. I'm just going to check my Google Photos to see if that picture is showing up so we can take a look at it there so you guys can see it. Nope. Hasn't loaded up yet. What I'll do is I'll actually end up taking that photo and putting it up on Twitter and everything like that from the live stream. But there's the Wheelie Blue again. Show you guys from this angle. Let me just turn the lighting a little more normal so you guys get an idea. It's definitely a nice dark blue. Like dark navy. That's the Wheelie Blue. Wheelie Blue for my Sea Blue phone. Yeah. Put that back down there. And turn our lighting back on. All right, so we went through the unboxing. We went through the initial setup. You guys got to see the fingerprint reader setup. You got to see the face unlock setup. Yeah, that's where we're at. The initial setup, you guys saw the comparisons with the other devices. So, what's on deck? What are we going to do? This is what's on deck. I'm going away to Banff this weekend. And while I'm out in Banff, so Banff is west of Calgary, mountains and everything like that. While I'm out there, I'll be creating content with my Pixel 7 Pro of the Pixel 7a and also content on the 7a to show demonstrations. That short form content will be showing up on photos mostly and some video on Twitter, but definitely video obviously with shorts, Instagram Reels, and TikTok at Zach Talks Tech on all of those. Any photos or video I take with the Pixel 7a, any photos or videos I take with this will show up on Zach Talks Pixel on Instagram. I know it gets a little confusing. I'm trying to streamline things. So there'll be a lot of short form content, and then we're going to get into the long form content. Hopefully I'll get an upload either tonight or tomorrow on Zach Talks Pixel. And I'm going in on content again with Zach Talks Pixel to jumpstart things again there and hopefully get some consistency going. The goal is to do 24 videos between now and the end of next quarter kind of thing. So end of October, end of September kind of thing. So that is the goal. A lot of it's going to seem kind of like, you know, everybody else is doing it, but you know what, it's my take and the way I'm doing content and whatnot, so that should be fun. And of course we'll continue the live streams here for in terms of follow-up, you know, impressions, things like that, but there won't be any live streams after tonight because I'm going to be out in the mountains and I don't know how good the internet is going to be at the chalet. I'm staying at a chalet. I don't know how good the internet's going to be there. Hopefully I can upload regular videos and pictures and whatnot, so that's the plan. That's the plan, people. So let me just pop this out one more time here. And actually, I'm going to double check my Google Photos here and see how that setup is going. Yeah, it's taking a while. I can show you guys the screen, I'm sure. But you guys can see how it's loading up the Google Photos. And you see that little bar at the top? It's taking its time. Sometimes it takes a while, especially with the new device and whatnot, because it's basically syncing with everything, right? So let's dive into the live chat here. If you guys have any more questions or whatnot, again, I appreciate everybody coming through tonight, this afternoon. Appreciate the super chats and the coffees and all that kind of good stuff. Appreciate you guys. No, not a Swiss Chalet. that's some good chicken, let me tell you. So going back here, you guys like the blue, got crimson here, crimson. I like them all. Definitely the blue, Gino says. Pepper says, that crimson sticks out, but I would probably go with the gray black. There you go. Going to Banff, B B-A-N-F-F, not Banff. Yeah, not the DeFranco thing. I'm going to Banff. B-A-N-F. I'm kind of congested because of the smoke and whatnot. It's been crazy out here. I know the back is plastic, but does it have a glass feel? You know what? I wouldn't have remembered that unless you told me right now. It feels... Okay, so that's... This is that. Okay. And then this is the Pixel 7 Pro. It feels the same. I'm not lying. I'm serious. It feels the same. It feels the same. It really does. Wow. Okay. I forgot that the back is plastic. If it brings down the price and it makes it more durable, I'm all for that. It feels the same though, dude. It really does. Yeah, it feels the same. Going back over here, Pixel 7 Pro. It feels the same. Even the front here. It feels the same. Oh, you know what? I didn't check out? I did not check out the... The refresh. Make sure that the smooth display is on. So you have to... I do a search for... Ah, look at this. So the smooth display is not even on right now. So let's go ahead... Yeah, here we go. Smooth display. You guys can see down here. Automatically refresh rate from 60 to 90. Boom. Okay, yeah. That makes a difference. You guys can't really tell. I don't think you guys can tell. But, yeah, that makes a big difference. Gonna have to get Twitter put on here pretty quick. Oh, yeah. Yeah, no, it doesn't feel like plastic at all. Feels really good. All right. Mason says, I understand this would defeat the purpose of what Lou was going for in the first place, but I wish they make the case in the thicker, more protective versions. My understanding is that I think they were playing around with that, but they decided to go all in with supporting like all the devices. So there are some similar polycarbonates, not polycarbonate, but like aramid fiber type cases, whatnot out there, as you guys know, that are very similar. But they don't support all devices. They may only support iPhones or only Galaxies and whatnot. I think what Lou and later case wanted to do is they wanted to go all in and support everything. So, the Xiaomi's, the Poco's, the like everything, right? Including the Pixels and whatnot. So, John says, if I had to put money, put in order my like, I would go from black, then crimson, then blue, then even though I like them all. Yeah, it's hard to pick one, right? They all look really good here, right? So, always a great job with the later cases. Michael says here, my son scratched the front of my Pixel 6 with a deep gash. I wish the display glass was better, but I know it's either easy to scratch or shatters. Yeah, I mean, glass is glass, right? Some stuff is a little more durable. After seeing comparisons, I'm considering grabbing the renewed 6 Pro from Amazon. Cameras and performance to be so close to the 7 Pro. The 6 Pro is still a great buy. It still is, absolutely. When you start putting these things side by side, you know this, Michael, and I think most of you guys know this. The differences are so minor, but definitely going from the 6A to the 7A, especially with the camera department and the refresh rate, it's quite a jump for such a small increase with the price. Been really good. AR1980 says, and essentially you can use the Pixel 7a but naked, knowing that the back is more durable to draws compared to the 7 Pro. Only worry is scratches. Yeah, I mean, it depends on what kind of person you are. I'm gonna be throwing one of these later cases on. A lot of the content this weekend will probably show the phone without, until I get that content done showing the phone just in its glory. But like privately, once I'm done recording and whatnot, I'll throw one of these on just to keep that surface protection and then take it off. And then when I get into more deeper review and whatnot on Zach Talks Pixel, I'll obviously be probably picking the crimson or the blue. So that is the plan. Oh my goodness. Terrible song. Anyway, people, thanks for coming through this afternoon. I really had a good time unboxing and setting this up. Again, thanks to Google Canada, made by Google, for sending this out. Appreciate you guys. Thank you. Lots more content to come. Lots of short form stuff this weekend. Hopefully one or two pieces on every platform every day. Thanks to everybody that's been watching the reels and the shorts and TikTok of the clips from the live streams made by Opus there and whatnot. It means a lot. I actually had one of them on Instagram Reels hit 10,000 views, which was pretty crazy. So, yeah. Not sure if there'll be content of this, like clips. I want to basically focus on making fresh content of the Pixel 7a and using the Pixel 7a going forward. I have a list and whatnot. It just, I want to make sure I do it in that Banff National Park in the mountain setting at the chalet. I used to call it chalet. Obviously, I'm wrong. But it should be a fun weekend here. Hopefully, the smoke is not too bad. It's supposed to be nice out there. It might rain on Sunday. And yeah. So, unless you guys have more questions or whatnot, I think we'll probably wrap things up here. I will be adding chapters for this live stream for people so you guys can rewatch it. I don't know if I'll be cutting off the ends or the start of the end or what, the start or the end like I normally do. But we'll see. We're playing around with some things here. So, is the bat a matte finish? So I guess you missed this earlier. Oh, that's okay. Yeah, it's a glossy. But because of the color, it doesn't feel like it's. It doesn't look like it's picking up too much. But yeah, it's a gloss. It's not a matte finish. I thought it was a matte finish as well. That's okay. I mean, we're gonna be throwing a case on there. You know, we got cat hair everywhere. I'm not sure why. This is really... Oh, yeah, that's right, because we have a cat. I forgot. Yeah, we have a cat. He's never around. He never joins the show. Anyway. People, thanks again for everybody showing up. Appreciate your faces and all that kind of good stuff. And I just lost my screens. I just lost my... There it is. Am I still live? Okay, there it is. Wow, what did I click? Okay. Anyway, people. You guys all have a good day. I'll see you guys on Twitter and all that good stuff. Instagram, TikTok, @ZachTalksTech. And yeah. Have a good day. Pixel 7a. Love it. Let's go.